Hello everyone, so I'm now ready with another topic, which is the conductivity of metal. So basically in this topic we want to find out what should be the conductivity upon which parameters it would depend at. So in order to find out the conductivity of metals, we need to basically, so as we already know that in metals the electrons are filled up to the conduction band, and these are basically oriented along all sorts of directions. So the nature is quite random so far as the velocities are of these electrons are concerned. So that means we need to look for the average behavior of these electrons, or we shall see the average properties, because they are too many numbers as well. So principles of statistical mechanics should directly apply to these systems. Now, so another thing, important thing is that, so what kind of electrons are these? So basically, because we are just talking about the metals, where the electrons still have insufficient energy to be in valence band. So therefore they are sticking into the conduction band. And that means their temperature is going to be also quite small. And that means we could model these electrons in the form of a cold electron gas. Okay. So this is going to be electrons. So this is at about T tends to zero basically. Okay. So that's what I meant by cold electron gas. So that, and then we should look for obviously the average properties. Now let's imagine that if we apply it an electric field, so what would happen to these electrons? So once you apply the electric field, so initially obviously they are oriented, their velocities are oriented in all sorts of random direction, and obviously these velocities are going to be different. Obviously they will lie into a certain velocity range, okay, and therefore they will follow some sort of distribution. Now once you apply an electric field, all of these electrons will get aligned anti-parallel to the direction of the electric field. Why anti-parallel? Because we know that the charges of electrons is negative rather than being positive. Okay, so that means that happens basically because of an electric force which has a strength of minus E times capital E, where minus E is basically the electron charge and E is the applied electric field. So due to this, this sort of force that is acting on each of the electrons, and that is kind of acting, so that's one thing, okay. And another thing is that these electrons will obviously be keep colliding with each other. So therefore, if you just think about a given electron, that means then the rest of the electrons will act as a medium, and therefore they will experience some sort of drag force. So therefore, let me just try to write what would be the net force applicable on a given electron. Okay, so obviously we have the charge of electron is minus E. Imagine the mass of electron is m. Okay, so with those sorts of things, let's write the net force. A net force on an electron, that's going to be F, let's say, and that's going to be F drag, which happens due to the medium, and then the F electric force. Why electric? Because we are just thinking about only electric field. Okay, so which is essentially an electrostatic, actually, if you are happy with this. Okay, So now what should be F drag? So that should be basically mass times some time tau, which is essentially referred as the collision time of, okay, collision time. This is the mass of electron times the velocity. Okay, and what should this velocity be? So obviously this could be written as the position vector. Okay, dot, where dot is having the usual meaning. And then the electric force, that's going to be minus E times the applied electric field. And what is the left hand side? That's going to be MR double dot according to the Newton's law. So this is actually going to be a differential equation of order 2. And in fact, we could also write this is going to be E by M, and E is basically E naught E to the power minus I omega t, where we had considered the electric wave to be oscillatory, which is how an electric wave look like. Okay, so now let me write a solution to this. So the solution to this let me just write the first order solution. Okay, basically this is R dot. So this is a differential equation basically in terms of R dot. So the solution to this at first order derivative, that's going to be how much? Well, this is going to be 1 plus 1 over tau. So its root will be minus 1 over tau. So we will have certain arbitrary constant e to the power minus t by 2. And then, so this is the complementary function. And then because of this non-zero thing on the right hand side, we will have a particular integral as well, which will be plus, well, how do we write particular integral? So we write this complementary function, then complementary function with a positive power. So basically e to the power p dx. So this is p plus q, and then q dt, because we have the dt. So this is e by m, e naught, and then e to the power minus I omega t dt. Okay, so let me just simplify it a bit more. That's going to be r double r dot, that's a e to the power minus t by tau plus e to the, in fact plus, there is a minus, so this is going to be e naught upon the mass of electron, and e to the power minus t by tau, e to the power plus t by tau, so that's 1 over tau minus I omega, and then we have t dt. So therefore the solution to this is going to be a e to the power minus t by tau. So this is straightforward, this is just e to the power ax, so you know that it is going to be e to the power ax upon a. So I'm just writing the answer, and then we will have obviously this power as well. Okay, so e to the power m, and then we will have e to the power minus t by tau e to the power t upon 1 over tau minus I omega. So now let's simplify this further to see that this is going to give you e to the power, well, this t by tau cancels, you will have e to the power minus I omega t, which will combine with this to form e itself. And now let me try to send the tau up. So we will have e tau by m, and then we will have 1 over 1 minus I omega tau, and then we will have the electric field. Okay, now what is t? Let me just check. So this is my equation number 2. And now since what is t? The collision time. So that is going to be the length of the conductor. Okay, so the length, normal length basically. And then upon the thermal velocity of an electron. So this is basically, you already know that length, and if suppose the temperature is T, then according to the Boltzmann law, that's going to be kBT upon m, and therefore we will have m upon kBT. So that's 3. Now according to this, what will be, and this is basically the equation equal to the collision frequency. Okay, But anyway, I'll write that later. If you wish, you could write it right now. So now, according to this, tau, because T is basically a very small number, so that means T would, as T tends to zero, that means your tau is going to be infinity, about infinity, but that's a very large number, and therefore, so this means A to the power minus T tau, that's going to be zero, so we could approximately write, so therefore, R dot is going to be minus E tau by M, 1 over 1 minus I omega t. Okay? So that's the approximate value of B R dot. And what is that basically? That's just the drift velocity if you wish to write. Okay? So now this is B. So therefore, we could write the current density. So this is my 4. So J is going to be, if so J is basically Q times B D, and Q is, suppose we have n number of electrons, so that's going to be Q is going to be Ne, and now BD for an electron is E tau by M, so that's going to be Ne square tau by M, and 1 minus omega tau. Well, I is missing, I should put I wherever it's missing. So that's the expression for J. But what is J? According to Ohm's law, this should be sigma times E. So from here, we could cancel the E's, and therefore, we will get an expression for the sigma. So let me write the final expression. So, according to this, so sigmas, as we know, E is get cancelled, and therefore sigma is going to be N E square tau by 1 minus I omega tau, N E square tau by M, okay? Or if you wish, you could also write N E square upon M, and 1 over tau, that's going to be, so I'm just multiplying with the tau, okay? So that's equation number 5. With, what is nu c? Nu c is defined as 1 over tau is the Collinson frequency. And that's going to be basically, let me recall the expression. So we had equation number 3, so according to that, it's going to be root kBT by M 1 over L. Okay? So now, let's see what would be the value for conductors. For conductors, let's see what would the omega be. So obviously for conductors, omega would be essentially 0. Okay? For conductors. So therefore, sigma, which is basically sigma dc, and that's going to be n e square by m nu c, okay, and which is essentially a very large number. Okay, why it's very large? Number one, number of electrons is very large, and then the uc is going to be, so nu c is basically zero sort of thing, so this is very large. Okay, so very large. And now this explains why the conductivity of electrons is of metals is very high. Okay, it's very high. And then the other observation is that collision frequency only depends upon the variable thing, which is the temperature, or conductivity in effect also. So let me just write what this conductivity is. So basically, conductivity is proportional. So let me write a final words. So this is going to be N E square by M, and now collision frequency, that's going to be N upon M upon KBT. So that's going to be N E square L root upon root KB or M KBT. So now what we learn is the following. Sigma is proportional to L and sigma is proportional to root of temperature. Okay. So as we raise the temperature of a material, somebody asks what happens? Obviously the conductivity will get reduced. Okay. So this completes about the conductivity of matters. Thanks.